Are you struggling to get adequate cellular signal at a job site? As discussed in a previous video, maintaining a strong cell signal is crucial to ensuring network connectivity for alarm routing to the central station and other AlarmNet services. It is not uncommon to encounter job site conditions that are unfavorable for strong cell signal when installing a fixed cellular communicator. In turn, the job site may require an external antenna to increase signal quality. But if not properly installed, it can have the opposite effect and even degrade the signal. Hi, I'm Mike with Resideo. Today I'd like to discuss the external antenna options that are available for AlarmNet communicators. We will look at the three external antenna options and cover some factors to consider when choosing the antenna and the antenna mounting location. These antennas are compatible with Vista and Lynx LTE communicators and support the frequency bands for LTE cell communication in North America. The first antenna, the Cell-ANT-HB, is a mounted antenna that is directly connected to the communicator housing or cabinet. This antenna is very easy to install and adds a 3 dB gain to the signal reception. In many cases, this antenna will provide sufficient quality of signal, or QoS, for a successful installation. With the 3 dB gain and simplicity of install, this antenna is a preferred choice for many. Another option that is fairly simple to install is the Cell-ANT-SMA, which is an indoor or outdoor remote-mounted antenna on a fixed cable about 10 foot long. This antenna does not provide 3 dB gain to the received signal, but is useful in scenarios where remote placement of the antenna to a higher point will provide a better quality of signal. The last antenna I want to discuss is the Cell-ANT-3DB, which is a remote-mounted indoor-outdoor 3 dB gain antenna which can accommodate a cable up to 50 feet in length. This antenna is useful when you need to mount the antenna further away from the communicator to achieve acceptable signal. The antenna is designed for outdoor use, but it can also be installed in attics, plenums, and other indoor areas. There are two design styles with this antenna, and both share the same part number. The older style is a radial mount antenna with 8 ground radials extending from the side. The newer style is a simple baton style with no ground radials. The specifications are the same for both, they just look different. This antenna comes in kits with a 25-foot or a 50-foot cable, and these should not be extended. For example, you should not couple together two 25-foot cables to equal 50 feet. Also, in some cases, the communicator may need to be relocated to accommodate the maximum cable length. This antenna is a little more difficult to install, and some careful thought should be exercised when considering this antenna and potential mounting locations. This leads to our next topic of discussion, where we will review some best practices to consider when using and installing an external antenna. To achieve the best results, it's important to place the antenna properly and in a location where it can receive a sufficient RF signal. The best locations for mounting are usually as high as possible and close to an exterior wall or a window. When searching for a mounting location, you may be able to power the communicator on battery power and carry it around to test for the best signal reception. This can be particularly helpful when planning the installation of the Cell-ANT-3DB with the 25 or 50 foot cable. Installing the antenna on wood, drywall, or plastic is recommended. Avoid large metal objects and make sure to install it away from any potential source of interference. Mounting the antenna within 12 inches of a metal object or surface is not recommended. Antennae are designed for a specific mounting orientation when installed. Mounting these antennas vertically to the ground plane is required. When mounted horizontally to the ground plane, they will not be able to capture the radio frequencies as intended, which can lead to signal degradation. In closing, I would encourage you to take a few moments to read the installation instructions for the antenna and the communicator you are installing to be certain you will achieve the most benefit for the installation.